Welcome all in class 9 on PCB design course. In this class, we will discuss about some of the basic components like inductor, capacitor, transformer, relay, which are mounted on PCB to obtain a specific task. So first in the series is inductor. So inductor is basically a coil of conducting wire. The parameters of interest of inductor are the number of turns of the inductor, the length of the inductor, the cross-sectional area of the inductor. The symbol for inductors is as shown in the slide. So first is the symbol for inductor for fixed inductor, and second is the symbol for variable inductor. Inductors are basically used to oppose any change of current passing through them. That is, inductors are used basically to provide a constant current. So the parameter of interest of inductor is inductance, and inductance is the tendency of an inductor to oppose a change in electrical current flowing through it. The inductance of an inductor depends upon the number of coils, the number of turns of the coil, second, cross-sectional area of the coil. The properties of inductor includes that the impedance offered by inductor is J omega L, where L is the inductance of the coil, omega is the angular frequency of the applied signal. The angular frequency of the applied signal is related with frequency of the signal by that omega is 2 pi f, where omega is the angular frequency, f is the frequency of the signal. So as impedance offered by inductor is J omega L, and for DC signal, the frequency of the DC signal is zero. So the impedance offered by inductor to DC signal is zero. That is, DC signal passes as it is through the inductor. However, for AC signal, as the frequency of the signal increases, then the angular frequency of the signal also increases, and when it is multiplied by inductor, it gives the impedance offered by inductor to the AC signal. So from the relation of impedance, it is evident that as frequency increases, the impedance offered by the inductor also goes on increasing. That is, inductors do not allow a high frequency signal to pass through it. This property of inductor is used to block high frequency noise from passing from the inductor. Inductor is also used to oppose sudden change in magnitude of current passing through it. Second property of inductor is that inductors are used to store energy in the form of magnetic field. So when current I flows through an inductor, the magnetic energy stored by inductor is given by 1 by 2 L I square. So as inductors are used to store the energy in the form of magnetic field, so inductor along with capacitors are used to make resonant circuits. That is, they can be used to produce oscillations of desired frequency. The frequency of resonant produced by inductor and capacitor are related by वन अपॉन टू पाई रूट ऑफ एलसी। द इंडक्टेंस ऑफ इंडक्टर रेंजेस फ्रॉम 1 माइक्रो हेनरी टू 20 हेनरी। सो मैनी इंडक्टर्स हैव मैग्नेटिक कोर मेड ऑफ आयरन और फेराइट मटीरियल। सो वेन वी यूज कोर ऑफ आयरन और कोर ऑफ फेराइट फॉर मेकिंग द इंडक्टर देन इट इज यूज टू इंक्रीज द इंडक्टेंस ऑफ द इंडक्टर दैट इज द कैपेसिटी टू स्टोर मैग्नेटिक एनर्जी इन इंडक्टर इंक्रीजेस वेन वी यूज द फेराइट कोर और वी यूज एन आयरन कोर फॉर मेकिंग द इंडक्टर। द नेक्स्ट कंपोनेंट दैट वी वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस इज कैपेसिटर। सो कैपेसिटर इज बेसिकली ए डिवाइस फॉर स्टोरिंग इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल चार्जेस। द कैपेसिटी ऑफ ए कैपेसिटर टू स्टोर चार्ज इज कॉल्ड कैपेसिटेंस। सो बेसिकली द कैपेसिटेंस इज द कैपेसिटी टू स्टोर द चार्ज बाय ए कैपेसिटर। सो कैपेसिटर बेसिकली कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू कंडक्टर्स इन क्लोज प्रॉक्सिमिटी एंड इंसुलेटेड फ्रॉम ईच अदर। सो द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द इंडक्टर इंक्लूड्स दैट द इंपीडेंस ऑफर्ड बाय कैपेसिटर इज 1 upon j omega c, which clearly indicates that impedance offered by the capacitor for DC signal is infinite. That is, the capacitor do not allow DC signal to pass through it, while for AC signal, impedance offered by inductor goes on decreasing with frequency. So this property of capacitor is used to block DC signal. It is also used to obtain to oppose sudden change in magnitude of voltage across a capacitor. Again, capacitors like inductors store energy in the form of electrical field when voltage is applied across capacitor. So the energy stored in capacitor can be calculated by the expression 1 by 2 CV square, where V is the applied voltage across the capacitor and C is the capacitance of the capacitor. So this property of capacitor is used to make resonant circuits using inductors. Next is series is transformer. A transformer is a device that transfer electrical energy from one alternating current circuit to one or more than or more other circuits. So transformer basically increases or reduces the voltage from primary to secondary. When it increases the voltage, then it is called step up transformer. When it reduces the voltage, it is called step down transformer. So transformers are either used to step up the voltage or they are either used to step up the voltage or to step up the current. However, the power from primary to secondary remains the same. That is, transfer of power from primary to secondary will always remain same. It is either voltage or current which is stepping up or stepping down. So transformers are rated in volt amperes or in kilovolt amperes. Generally, transformers has a primary and secondary sides which acts as input and output of the transformer. Primary is obtained by using a coil having np turns wound on a core, and secondary is obtained by using a coil having ns turns wound on the same core. The voltages and the currents in primary and secondary are related with the number of turns in primary and secondary by using the relation that voltage in primary divided by voltage in secondary is equal to current in secondary divided by current in primary is equal to number of turns of the primary coil divided by number of turns in the secondary coil. From here we can also conclude that Vp multiplied by Ip is equal to Vs multiplied by Is, that is input power across primary is same as output power across secondary. In centered tap transformer, instead of two, there are three terminals in the secondary as shown in the slide. So here voltages along primary and secondary are related by, if this is the center tap transformer and Vp is here the primary voltage and Np is the number of turns of the primary winding. Na here is number of turns in the secondary, upper part of the secondary. Nb here is number of turns in the coil in lower part of secondary. Va is voltage across upper part of the secondary. Vb is the voltage across lower part of the secondary. So Va, which is voltage across secondary, is related to voltage on primary side by Va is equal to Na by Np multiplied by Vp. Similarly, on lower part, voltage on lower part is Nb, number of turns in the secondary, divided by Np multiplied by Vp, primary voltage. So next is the relay. Relay is again a very common component that is used on PCBs. A relay is an electrical operated switch. So relays are used where it is necessary to control a circuit by an independent low power signal. For example, in the slide we have taken a relay, and this relay is controlled by low current or low power supply. So when it is switched on, a high current or high voltage is connected from source to the load by using relay. However, if the low current circuit is off, source is not connected to the load. So there are generally two types of relays, which are called electromechanical and solid state relays. In electromechanical relays, the contacts are opened or closed by a magnetic force. However, in solid state relays, the solid state relays uses semiconductor switches and optoelectronics instead of magnetism and moving contacts to make or to break the contact. Generally, we use a 5-pin relay terminal, and the 5 pins of relay terminal are pin 1 for positive power supply and pin 2 for negative power supply. So the low voltage controlled power supply is applied on pin 1 and pin 2. A high voltage signal is applied on pin 3. So the power which is high voltage power which is available on pin 3 can be connected to pin 4 or it may be connected to pin 5. Pin 4 is normally closed. However, pin 5 is normally open. That is, pin 4 is always connected with pin 3. However, when we apply a control signal between pin 1 and pin 2, the pin 3 is connected with pin 5. So here a low power controlling signal is applied between pin 1 and pin 2. A high power signal is applied on pin 3. When low power controlling signal is not available, pin 3 is connected with pin 4, that is normally closed pin. When low power controlling signal is available, pin 3 is connected with pin 5. So these were the some of the components that we want to discuss in this class. Thank you very much.